Renting versus buying, which is better? Well, it all depends on you and your situation. And to help you make the decision, we've invited TJ Larson back with his great advice as always. TJ, good to see you.
Good to see you.
You say there are lots of things to consider when it comes to renting versus buying. And the first one being, how long are you going to be in the home? You have to consider that first.
You do. You know, I started a property management company back in 2007 to complement our sales company. It put me in a good position to be a little unbiased in this. Usually you've got the leasing professional and the sales professional fighting this out and trying to convince that client to move in that direction. Being unbiased on it, I can sit in and I can say, first question, how long do you plan to be in that home? If you're going to flip that home quickly, then I would recommend don't make the purchase at all. If you're going to stay in the home for a year, it's better to rent for 12 months. If you don't know the area, it's better to go ahead and rent and learn the area at that point. Mm-hmm. So that's the best way to do it.
So a year, is that kind of your gauge? If it's less than a year, don't go ahead and rent. If it's more?
I use 2 years as the minimum on that. 2 years, you've got a lot of closing costs that are associated with that purchase. Usually as the home is appreciating, we hope, you'll be able to offset those closing costs.
Okay, so for a lot of people, renting obviously could be a better option, like you said, depending on how long they're going to stay in the home. Is it considered a waste of money, though? I always hear people say that, oh, I feel like I'm just throwing my money away in renting. Do you think that's the case?
I hate to hear that. You know, you've got to live somewhere. Unless you're going to live on the street, you've got to pay some money to live somewhere. So it's not throwing money away. You certainly don't get some tax exemptions that come from buying a home. But again, you've got to pay to live somewhere. So it could be a very good decision for the right person. Again, learn the area. You want to find out exactly where you want to live. You might need to save for a down payment. All of those things are factors.
I think that's what it's really good for, too, is though you can learn the neighborhood and learn the area and decide whether you like living there before you make that big commitment.
Yeah, we've got transplants that are coming into Charlotte. You're staying in an extended stay motel for, you know, 2 weeks, and you say, I need to buy next week. I don't know if we can learn the area that fast.
Yeah, you don't. I don't think you do. Is renting cheaper than buying? I mean, you know, like you said, the down payment when you're buying a home, the closing costs to consider. Is renting cheaper?
If we take out the closing costs, if we take out the tax savings on it, actually renting is going to be a little bit less expensive on a monthly basis. When you buy, you have to pay principal, interest, taxes, and insurance. And all those things will be slightly more. That's, again, if we're going to compare a rental property that's very similar to the home that you're going to purchase. So don't expect those numbers to line up one for one.
Yeah. Talk about maintenance expenses. Of course, that's a big cost if you rent from a landlord or an individual.
Yeah, there's two people you can rent from in normal circumstances. You've got a large-scale apartment complex. That's typically going to have maintenance guys that are on staff. They're going to change your air filter. They're going to change your light bulbs. They're going to do absolutely everything for you. Go out there and freshen the pine straw. Usually when you're renting from an individual, you're going to have to take care of changing out the air filter, changing the light bulbs. But if you've got a roof leak, they're going to come in and they're going to take care of that for you. If the water heater blows up in the middle of the night, they're going to take care of those items for you.
Okay, and what about tax incentives? I mean, is that right there a motivator to buy?
It is, and that's really the great thing that this sort of balances this out. You do have great tax savings when you go to buy a property. You're building equity in the home, but you're also writing off those those interest payments. You're also writing off your tax payments. So for many people, that is the key motivator. If you're going to be in that home for, again, over 2 years, you could build up some great equity in the home, have a great write-off on it. Also, capital gains tax, if it's a principal residence, you won't have to pay taxes on the profit of that on that home.
There's lots of stuff to consider. You can visit TJ's website at mytownhome.com. TJ, as always, great advice. Thank you so much. We'll see you next week. Well, if you're in the market